Hi, my name is Victor, and today I will be showing you how to build a PVC air cannon that shoots tennis balls. The parts you will need to build this PVC tennis ball air cannon are listed in the description box below. The first step in making this tennis ball cannon will be to modify the sprinkler valve. You will first remove the solenoid. Now you will take off all 8 screws on the sprinkler valve. After removing the lid, you will be left with 8 screws. Take care of the screws, do not keep them close. And now you are left with a splatter and the spring. You do not need to modify them in any way, you just need to modify this part. The first step will be to drill a 1/2-inch hole right in the center. When you are finished drilling your 1/2-inch hole, you will then put Teflon tape on one side of your 1/2-inch nipple. Then you will insert it to the top of the sprinkler valve. Once you have inserted your 1/2-inch nipple, you will then get a piece of masking tape and close off this stem. Once you have sealed the stem with masking tape, you will then get JB Welder and fill in the little leaks of air that can come through these small holes. Once the hole is filled with JB Welder, you will then put the sprinkler valve off to the side to let dry for at least 24 hours. Make sure to not lose any parts. The next step in building this air cannon is to drill a hole in the 3-inch end cap large enough to accept this Schrader valve. Once the hole is drilled, you will then insert this Schrader valve. Once your Schrader valve is inserted, you will then go on to gluing. Make sure you are in a well-ventilated area. I'll be gluing the air chamber. The parts you will need are a 2-foot 3-inch section of PVC, a 3-inch end cap with a Schrader valve inserted, a 3-inch coupler, a 3-inch to 2-inch reducer, and a 2-inch to 1-inch reducer. You will also need plenty of PVC glue and primer. First step of making the air chamber will be to glue the 3-inch end cap with the Schrader valve inserted onto one end of the 2-foot 3-inch section. Next step in making the air chamber will be to glue the 3-inch coupler onto the other end of the 3-inch PVC pipe. Coupler, you will then glue the 3-inch to 2-inch reducer onto the other side of the 3-inch coupler. Now you will glue the 2-inch to 1-inch reducer onto the 3-inch to 2-inch reducer. The last step in making the air chamber will be to glue a 1.5-inch section of 1-inch PVC onto a 1-inch male adapter, which will then glue into the 2-inch to 1-inch reducer. The air chamber is now completed. Part in making this PVC air cannon is to make the barrel. The parts in front of me are a 4-foot section of 2.5-inch PVC, 2 2.5-inch couplers, 1 2.5-inch to 2-inch reducer, and another 2-inch to 1-inch reducer. Make sure to use plenty of glue and primer. The first step in making the barrel will be to glue a 2.5-inch coupler onto the 2.5-inch piece of PVC. After gluing the 2.5-inch coupling onto the 2.5-inch barrel, you will now glue the 2.5-inch to 2-inch reducer onto the 2.5-inch coupling. Now you will glue the 2-inch to 1-inch reducer onto the 2.5 to 2-inch reducer. Before the last step, we will glue a 2.5-inch coupler onto the front of the barrel. The last step in making the barrel will be to glue a 1.5-inch section of 1-inch PVC onto another 1-inch male adapter, which will then glue into the 2-inch to 1-inch reducer. The barrel is now completed. Making the stock. The parts in front of me are a 1-inch to 3/4 elbow. On one side they need threads for the 3/4. And we will also need a double-sided 3/4 threaded piece. The first step will be to put Teflon tape on each side of the threaded piece. Now that we have put Teflon tape on each one of the sides, we will now put this into each one of the elbows. The last step in building the stock will be to connect a 1.5-inch section of 1-inch PVC onto a 1-inch female adapter that will then connect onto either one of the elbows. For the final step, you will take a 1.5-inch section of 1-inch PVC pipe and connect it into a male adapter, and then the other side will go into one of the elbows on the buttstock. We will now be drilling a hole in the chamber to accept this PSI gauge. The PSI gauge is now installed. To connect the barrel onto the air chamber, we will use the buttstock. The buttstock will run from the barrel, and down here it'll go to the sprinkler valve and into the chamber. We will first put Teflon tape on this male adapter on the barrel to make sure there are no air leaks. The buttstock is now connected. All the gluing is finished. Now all we must do is wait 24 hours for the glue on the gun and the sprinkler valve to set. After that, we will then give it a nice paint job. Now that we have waited a full 24 hours for the glue on the gun to set and the sprinkler valve, we will now assemble the sprinkler valve and attach it to the gun. Then we will give it a nice paint job. We will now be showing you how to reassemble the modified sprinkler valve. The first step in reassembling the modified sprinkler valve will be to get the splatter and put it in the sprinkler valve. The second step will be to put the spring in the center of the splatter. Now we will put the lid of the sprinkler valve onto the spring and attach it to the sprinkler valve with all 8 screws. Before we attach the blowgun, we will first need to put the sprinkler valve onto the gun. We will now attach the modified sprinkler valve onto the gun. The first step in attaching the modified sprinkler valve will be to attach the sprinkler valve onto the buttstock. Make sure the arrows are facing towards the buttstock. Before attaching the chamber, you will first attach the blowgun onto the modified sprinkler valve. Now that we have attached the blowgun onto the modified sprinkler valve, we will now attach the air chamber and onto the other side of the sprinkler valve. Make sure to use Teflon tape. chamber, we will get a piece of wood and put it in between the chamber and the barrel. We will use a hose clamp to secure it. The gun is now completed. Now all we must do is give it a paint job. We have now painted the cannon. We are going to go test fire the cannon. Make sure the location you are going to fire your cannon is well suitable.
We'll now be test firing the gun at 60 PSI. Make sure to wear safety goggles and have a parent unit around you. Easy 100 yarder. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to like and share this video with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe.